It's a 1957 300 SL Gullwing Mercedes, one of the most fantastic cars ever built. It's a cornerstone to most big collections. And this is one of the last Gullwings produced. 1957 was the last year. This is number 33 out of 76 cars that were built that year. And therefore, because of that, it makes it pretty important. The restoration was done in 2006 by Andrew Bach, and Andrew totally stripped the car to bare metal, did a complete restoration on the car, and then during the restoration process, he added certain things like the fitted luggage to the back that wasn't with the car originally, and then he sourced out a full set of Rudge wheels, and these are factory Rudge wheels. Even though they didn't come with the car, they still make a huge difference in the looks of the car as well as the value. And then the really unusual thing about this car is it comes with a travel kit, tool kit. And that was consisted of spare parts such as a clutch, valves, valve springs, all sorts of seals, so that if you broke down somewhere where there wasn't any parts available for one of these cars, you'd have enough parts to actually fix the car right on the side of the road. The toolkit is supposedly worth $30,000 to $40,000 alone. So that raises the price of this car drastically. The Gullwing was so far ahead of its time in the way that it was built with its suspension and the huge engine in front. It was built to be a race car, very successful at Le Mans, the Mille Miglia. John Fitch drove one of these to many victories. Mercedes had designed and developed such a fantastic racing car that it beat everybody. So it's a great race car that they developed for racing purposes and then brought it to the public to use on the street. So it's fast, it's nimble. So when somebody puts a Gullwing in their collection, they're buying a piece of automotive history, race history, as well as beauty. And it's the cornerstone of any great collection. Everyone should have a Gullwing.
I love coming to Scottsdale every year. It's such a great break from the Connecticut winters. But I'm here to work. I'm here to get a job done.
Well, it's time to see where they placed the Gullwing. Go take a look at it. I was representing this car for a client back in Connecticut. I had a previous client of mine fly up and take a look at the car, and he bought it. There it is. He'd owned it for about 3 weeks when I got a phone call one day from him, and he said, listen, I'm going to take the car to auction, and I'd like you to represent it for me.
I think the car presents better with the doors open, so I think we're going to leave those open.
Some clients keep cars for 30, 40 years. Some clients keep cars for 2 to 3 weeks. You just never know.
The Gullwing is one of the most iconic sports cars of any era. We actually have two Gullwings in the sale, one alloy-bodied Gullwing, which I'll show you in a bit, and then this car. What makes this Gullwing so special is the restoration on it is absolutely spectacular. One of the finest I've ever seen. The color combination, it has Rudge wheels, which they use just on the race cars. It could be special ordered for some of the road cars. The car also is fitted with the optional luggage for touring. If you go on a weekend away, fun thing about a Gullwing is the tilt steering wheel helps you get in and out of the car easily, or more easily. And just locks in like that. This car is fitted with a radio. It's loaded with all sorts of extras. Our estimate on the car is $850,000 to $1 million.
Bring on lot 46. It's the 57 Mercedes-Benz 300 SL Gullwing. Please note that the belly pans and original toolkit and manuals accompany the sale of this vehicle. It comes with a special touring toolkit, a very rare and desirable option.
No phone bidders.
Restoration and color combination. Lot 46, the gorgeous 300 SL Gullwing.
Where would you like to start me, ladies and gentlemen? 500,000, thank you. 500,950, I'll take.
Straight in at 500,000. 50. 550 in front of me, also 600 would you like? At 550. 600 now, 600,000 in. 600, 620. 620. 640. 640. 660. 660 now. At 640. 660 in the middle. 660. 680. You're out at 660 now. Right in the middle at 660. And 680, may we say.
There didn't seem to be very much action in the room, not too many players. There was bidding from three people on the car. It slowly moved up.
720, the bid's against you, sir. I'll take 730. 730, 740 now. Now 740, sir. I don't mind taking another 10 from you, sir. I've got now 740 on the left, thank you. At 740 in the front row, 740, 750. 750. At 750,000, the bid is against you. 760, 760. 770 now, sir. 770. 780 now, sir. 780 if you'd like to bid me. At 770,000, 780. 790 now, sir. The bid's at 790. 800 now? No. For the first time, ladies and gentlemen, I'm selling the car at 790,000. For the second time, at $790,000. For the third and the last time, at $790,000. It's all finished at $790,000. All done. Sold your car, sir. Thank you so much.
Paddle 315 at $790,000. Sold to you. Thank you very much.
It was hammer sold at 790, but before the auction began, I met with David Gooding, and we came to a compromise that as long as I was able to get my reserve price, he could sell the car for a lesser amount at the hammer. He hammered it, sold at 790. I'm still receiving my reserve price that I had signed a document with. Everyone's happy. It was a compromise.